Hello everyone, Quicklearn 360 brings to you a fun of learning, knowledge and better understanding. Stay connected, stay tuned to us. Today's topic is urea cycle. I, Sapan Kesha, welcomes you all. Let's start understanding. Dear students, once again welcome to Quicklearn 360. Now let me start with introduction about urea cycle. I will briefly introduce this to all of you. Urea is the end product of protein metabolism. In transamination, amino acid convert to glutamic acid and then to ammonia by oxidative deamination. The nitrogen of amino acid convert to ammonia is toxic to the body. It is converted to urea and then detoxified. As such, urea accounts for 80 to 90% of the nitrogen containing substances excreted in urine. Urea is synthesized in liver and transported to kidney for excretion in urine. Urea cycle in the honor of Krebs and Hanslet, also known as a Krebs-Hanslet cycle. Urea has two amino groups, one derived from ammonia and other from aspartate. The third group, keto, is obtained from carbon dioxide. So this is how the molecule of urea is formed. Urea synthesis is a five-step cyclic process with a distinct enzyme. The first two enzymes are located in mitochondria, the rest are present in cytosol of the cell. Let us see the names of all enzymes involved in various steps. In mitochondria, step 1 is catalyzed by carbamoyl phosphate synthase 1, very commonly known as CPS1. Step 2 by ornithine transcarbamylase, while in cytosol, step 3 by arginosuccinate synthase, step 4 by arginosuccinase and step 5 by arginase. Now let's see steps in urea synthesis. Step 1 is the synthesis of carbamoyl phosphate, step 2 is the formation of citrulline, step 3 is the synthesis of arginosuccinate, step 4 is the cleavage of arginosuccinate and step 5 is the formation of urea. We will now discuss each step in detail.
CPS1 contains carbon dioxide and ammonia in the presence of 2 ATP and NAG to form carbamoyl phosphate. It is an irreversible reaction which converts ATP into ADP.
Carbamoyl phosphate is converted to citrulline by ornithine transcarbamylase. Ornithine is regenerated and used in urea cycle. The role of ornithine is comparable to that of the oxaloacetate in citric acid cycle. Ornithine and citrulline are basic amino acids. In step 3, citrulline condenses with the aspartate in the presence of arginosuccinate synthase to produce arginosuccinate. This step requires ATP, which is cleaved to AMP and pyrophosphate. The second amino group of urea is incorporated in this reaction only. In step 4, arginosuccinate is cleaved by the enzyme arginosuccinase to give fumarate and arginine. Arginine is the immediate precursor for the formation of urea. The fumarate liberated here provides a connecting link with the TCA cycle and gluconeogenesis. Step 5 is the formation of urea. Arginine in the fifth and final step break into urea and ornithine by the enzyme arginase. Ornithine, so regenerated, enters mitochondria for its use in urea cycle. Arginase is the mostly found in liver while the rest of the enzyme of urea cycle present in other tissues. Arginase is activated by cobalt and manganese. Ornithine and lysine may compete with arginine via competitive inhibition. Arginine synthesis may occur in many tissues, but only the liver can ultimately produce urea. That's the only importance of step 5.
Overall reaction and energetics of urea cycle. 2 ATP are utilized for the synthesis of carbamoyl phosphate. 1 ATP is converted to AMP and pyrophosphate to produce arginosuccinate, which equals to 2 ATP. Hence, 4 ATP are actually consumed. This is how we will overall represent urea cycle in a single reaction.
So now let us see the summary of urea cycle. In step 1, condensation of ammonia with carbon dioxide to form carbamoyl phosphate.
This step consumes 2 ATP. It is a rate limiting and irreversible step. The second reaction is also mitochondrial. Ornithine is the first member of the reaction. Hence, this cycle is also known as an ornithine cycle. Citrulline is transported to cytosol by transport system. In step 3, second amino group of urea is incorporated. It requires ATP, which is cleaved to AMP and pyrophosphate. PPI immediately broken down to PI. Step 4 is the formation of arginine, or we call cleavage of arginosuccinate to produce fumarate and arginine. Fumarate is converted to oxaloacetate, then transaminated to aspartate. Arginase is the fifth and final enzyme that cleaves arginine to yield urea and ornithine. Always remember, arginine synthesis occurs in many tissue, but only liver can produce the urea. So when we summarize the significance of urea cycle, toxic ammonia is converted to non-toxic urea. Synthesis of important amino acid, ornithine and arginine. This defect in urea cycle lead to ammonia intoxication. So, that's how we complete urea cycle. Thank you.